And there he is at the news desk. He is the best newsman in the business. And let's remind you, of course, he is a sexy boy, but he is not your boy toy. He is not to be objectified and treated like a piece of meat, even though he has enormous rippling muscles. And I do suspect may, in fact, be pharmaceutically enhanced.
Yeah, that's a possibility.
How are you, Eazy-G?
Yeah, not too bad. I was watching the some highlights from Monday Night. I don't know if they call it Monday Night Raw anymore. I don't know what they call it. I guess it's new tag team called DOA. I guess it's called Dead on Arrival. Two big boys. And they got that guy from The Shield there. I forget his name.
Dean Ambrose?
No, the other guy.
Seth Rollins.
Yeah, Seth Rollins. They're a bad guy now. And they were getting a smackdown on Rey Mysterio, and he was saying the old famous words, but it didn't have to be this way.
Right.
But it was, though.
But it
they
was.
They let him lay in the ring, and then they walked away.
Left him laying.
And they had a pipe with him.
Yes, it's all very tragic.
But he's a bad guy.
He is a bad guy. He's better as a bad guy than a good guy, in my opinion.
Oh, definitely.
Yes. And also joining us here in the studio, that's right. Got his entrance music ready, too. That's right. Jon Hopwood is here. How are you, sir?
All right.
I noticed you have a mug on your head.
I do.
Yes.
How'd that happen?
Now, you don't know this, Eazy-G, but Jon Hopwood texted me earlier. He told me two things. He said he's got a mug on his head, and he wants Private Eyes by Hall & Oates to be his new theme music. And I said, that's fine, but we all have to do the hand claps. Ready? Private Eyes, they're watching you. They see your every move. You'll get it. Private Eyes,
they're watching you. Just one clap?
Just pretend you're in the video.
What video?
The video for Private Eyes.
There was a video?
Of course there was. Hall & Oates has a million videos.
They do?
Yes. You have excellent taste in music, sir.
I don't remember the video of Sleazy Lover. Is that one of their songs?
Swayze Lover?
Sleazy.
Sleazy? Sleazy Lover?
Why does everything sound different?
I don't know.
Sounds like I have something on my head.
Yeah, you do have something on your head.
Feels like I have something on my head.
All right, here we go. Ready?
Oh, all right.
You guys are really bad at hand claps. Oh, they, yeah.
It would help if I knew the song.
Right. You don't know Private Eyes by Hall & Oates. I know how much you love the H and O.
Is it Sleazy Lover or Easy Lover?
There's a song called Easy Lover, but that's actually Phil Collins.
Oh, I was about to say, that's a good song.
Phil Collins and Philip Bailey of Earth, Wind & Fire. They did a duet called She's an Easy Lover.
Well, that's good. That's not Hall & Oates.
Well, last week or so, Huey Lewis, I guess, has lost his hearing, and he was like thinking of taking his life.
Well, oh, my God. Wow.
You know, the members of The Who, well, Keith Moon's long gone, and John Entwistle's gone.
But thankfully he did not, because he doesn't want to be on Paul Cromwell's death video.
Right. He needs a new drug, one that won't make him sick.
Yes.
I remember that video.
One that won't make him lose his hearing and make him feel 3 feet thick.
That would be tragic if he took his life. That would be tragic. That would not be good at all.
Both Roger Daltrey and Pete Townsend lost a significant portion of their hearing.
Also Brian Johnson of AC/DC. Yeah. That's why he retired.
They performed in front of the stacks of amplifiers in those days.
I might have seen Huey Lewis in the news right here downtown Manchester by the river.
You might have seen them performing at the Hop Knot, our official sponsor at 1000 Elm Street.
I don't know about that.
See what I did there? That's why I'm an afternoon drive. The Hop Knot, Manchester's premier establishment for delicious gourmet pretzels. They have craft beer, they have wine, they have board games, they have trivia night every Wednesday night at 7 p.m.
And they have ceramic mug hats.
Oh, wow. No, that's not an actual mug hat.
It's not.
That's actually just a hat that you're wearing that you put a mug on top of.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
Eazy-G, I don't know if you know this, but John has a head injury. He was concussed recently. So we have to explain some things to him.
I can believe it.
Yes.
Where's my grandson?
He died.
Oh shoot. Nice. No. I already set the card out.
Well, he's dead. Sorry.
No way to get that 50 cents back.
Nope. That's true, actually. You might be able to fill out a form with the post office. By the way, the Hop Knot on the 20th is having their ugly sweater party.
They are?
Yes.
Do you have an ugly sweater?
No, I'm going to have to procure one. I don't wear sweaters usually.
You don't?
I get overheated in them.
Well, you are hirsute.
I am. Yeah. I have so much body hair. I honestly, and forgive me if that's TMI, but I don't even like wearing a heavy coat in the winter.
Yeah.
I try to dress as lightly as I think I can get away with.
He's got fur like a Norwegian forest cat, you know? They've got that big outer layer, and then they got the wool underneath.
I definitely did not need to know that.
Right.
What?
Well, you should have
assumed
it.
You don't like cats?
Yeah. What do you have against cats?
As long as we don't mention dogs in front of him, we're fine.
Okay, now that's just offensive. Eazy-G, why don't you pull that mic up a little bit?
Oh, yeah, my first time here.
Yes, you're new here, yes.
It sounds like Peter White now.
Yes, yes.
How many times I got to tell you that?
We will be joined in just a few minutes at 4:30 p. Eastern time by Truth. True Rhymes uniquely teaching hope. I had to think for a second because I keep
you got the fur ball. Come on, cough it up.
I keep saying, I don't know why I stumble on that. I did that the last time we had him on too.
Mm.
True Rhymes, uniquely teaching hope. There's something about it in my brain. I'm telling you, I'm suffering from adult onset dyslexia. It's quite tragic.
That is the stage name?
Yes, which is even worse than what's happening to Huey Lewis. Yes, that is his stage name. His legal name is not that.
And I can't wait to ask him that famous question. I'm going to say it till he's on the air.
Yes, Eazy-G, the best newsman in the business, has a standard question that he asks all of our musical guests.
Don't announce it, please.
Oh, no.
Casey's listening.
No, don't you worry.
I want to shock him.
I won't. I know you will, yes. He's going to be like, that is the greatest interview question ever.
Well, so far I've asked three of the artists they've had on your show in the last month or so, and mm-hmm. two out of three have played in a question that I've answered.
Yeah, you are.
Is this my grandson coming?
No.
If it's the Mac show in the afternoon, it's time for the sirens.
Right.
Ooh, where are they? Are they Zeftig?
Once during the show, they. We're going to have an ambulance come by or a fire engine or a police.
Is that, you could tell it was a fire engine because his tail went up?
I don't know what it is. It's some kind of siren.
Terribly hurtful and cruel. Top fan, Brian Mackey, all the way from Idaho, joins us. He says, hey, Matt. Hey, Eazy-G. He didn't say hi to you, John. He was probably put off by the mug on your head.
Oh.
John Midas Manning, frequently known as DJ Midas, is in there. He says, hi, guys. Midas, of course, hosts Late Night Delight, which you can hear every Saturday and Sunday night beginning at 12 midnight here on WMNH.
Afternoon Delight.
No, it's Late Night.
Oh, it's not Afternoon Delight.
Correct. Mary LeMay joins us. Isaac Sierra, better known as Truth, is in the Facebook live chat. He says, hello, everyone. I'm Truth, T-R-U-T-H. Of course, True Rhymes, uniquely teaching hope. I'll be live on the air interviewing with Matt in about 20 minutes.
I thought he was at 4:30.
Yeah.
What time's it now?
4:13.
Damn.
I know,
thought it
right?
was like 4:30 already.
No, I know. The show goes by so fast.
Oh, yeah.
He says, it's an honor to be chatting with this man again. Well, thank you. I'll definitely try to watch my language more this time.
Oh.
I did have to hit the dump button last time he was on because he kind of forgot. What are you doing over there?
I'm reacting to him calling a Yeti a man.
Right.
Oh, Jesus. I've come on the wrong day.
Brian Mackey says, LOL, there was a video, referring to Hall & Oates.
There was?
Yes, there was a video. Tony Petrello joins us in the Facebook live chat.
Is he the one that is engaged in a war against my grandson, a war against Christian?
Tony Petrello?
Is he the Tony that's engaging the war on Christian?
He could be. I don't know. I don't know about that. My goodness.
Oh, boy.
Peter White, you gentlemen might be familiar with, of The Morning Show with Peter White. He joins us in the Facebook live chat.
Hey, Peter.
Is that the tall guy?
He's
with the Buddy Holly glasses?
He is tall. More like Sam Cedar, but a very tall Sam Cedar. Yeah, Peter's about 6'10".
Hey, I'm Matt. He wants to get you ready for bed.
What?
He said that whenever the lights go down at night, he gets tired.
Well, he's amorous. Ooh. You know, a lot of those big guys are.
He has to get up early.
Well, that's true. Yeah. He has to get up
early. I wonder if he's got his pajamas on yet, Pat.
Well, he,
I don't know. Why are you thinking about Peter White in his pajamas?
I don't know. Just make good radio.
Do you think he wears a onesie?
I don't know.
And are you imagining him right now? Are you imagining Peter White in a onesie right now?
Look at his eyes. They're closed.
He's got a mental
ecstasy.
Image.
Ecstasy.
Oh, yes. He's imagining.
I'm just trying to make good radio.
He's imagining Peter White in a onesie with the zipper that comes down the front. Aren't you? It's okay. Boy. It's okay.
Either that or a one-piece, long thermal underwear with a drop, what do they call that? A drop drawer in the back?
Sure.
What is it called?
I don't
drop
know.
Drop panel?
I know.
Will you unbutton it when you're in the outhouse?
Oh.
What is it called?
You see that photo the other day with Joel and the turkey, and he had his white bathrobe on Jon Hopwood?
No, I didn't.
Oh, I saw that.
Oh, that was funny.
I saw the one where you looked like an elf.
Peter White points out it's almost 4:20.
Well, sometime soon the days are going to get longer again, Peter White.
Yeah, next week. Next Monday.
That's our 4:20
air horn. Next Monday, because Sunday is
the
first day of winter, and then it's going to start getting a little bit longer.
Thank goodness. Let's see. Jordan Fox says, oh, wow, Matt Hopwood and Eazy-G? We're in for some trouble. Oh, my goodness.
What? Say what?
Brian Mackey says, Hopwood, sorry, didn't see you. Mary LeMay says, hi, Matt. Ooh. I have 4 girl cats. I love my girl all my heart. They nothing wrong have in cats, ha. Huh? Okay. Tony Petrillo says, negative. No, he is not the one in a war against, your grandson, Christian.
He's not in the war on Christian?
No. Chavez Nick joins us in the Facebook live chat.
Well, that's a good name.
Yeah, you like that? You like the, because it reminds you of Hugo Chavez and you're like a communist? Is that what's going on there?
Well, I think it's his nickname is actually Nick Chavez.
I didn't know that.
How many cats do you have, Matt?
Yeah. We have 2.
I know
ooh.
Brooklyn Mike, who's his thermometer over there, I think he has like 3 or 4 cats.
Three or four cats.
He loves cats.
I love cats as well.
I got somebody sent me a picture of Peter White in his underwear.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, my God.
That's terrible. We still haven't seen Eazy-G's celebrity nudes flood the internet yet, but we know it's coming.
Did you see that Facebook live show when they were at my room?
Yes, that was wonderful. What a wonderful surprise. By the way, okay, so I have to tell you something.
I was not allowed to be on Facebook until January. Well, I shut myself off.
So oh, that's right.
I haven't seen it.
I was listening.
Because of nudity?
Well, no, because of he gave it up for Lent.
No, I just gave it up for Christmas.
For Christmas.
Nudity?
No, that too, yes.
That too.
Oh.
But, okay, so.
Is that why she didn't go out with you?
Maybe.
I was listening live, so I don't always catch the morning show live because I'm not a morning person.
Right.
But I caught that part of the show. Oh yeah, you know that because I called in. I honestly thought, you know how you were skeptical, like you thought it was a bit, and it wasn't real. I thought the same thing. I absolutely thought the same thing, and then I see on my phone, I get a Facebook notification that the morning show is live, and I'm like, why are they live now? That's interesting. And I look, and it's the guys at your place soaking up the TV.
Yeah,
like,
it was funny because Gonzo
was
doing some Facebook Live, and I guess he did a rotten job. Sorry if he's listening.
Oh, no.
Peter White was saying, keep your day job.
Mm.
He was trying to film my lousy toes.
Poor Gonzo.
It didn't come out very good.
No, but I thought that was that was so nice. What they did for you.
I'm still in a state of shock about
the whole thing. I thought that was lovely.
Enormous kindness.
Yes.
What? What are you talking about? I was reading about Peter's union suit.
Oh.
It's called a flap.
Oh, a drop.
I know they only keep shows. I mean, they only keep things on Facebook for a limited amount of time. So when I
they
log
do
on, when I log on January 2nd at the library, I'm assuming that video from Facebook Live on the yesterday on the 16th of December will be.
No, that's not true. Things don't.
No, when I took off Lent for 50 days, the I don't think the stories stay on. Maybe I'm wrong, but
they do. No, they stay there.
But they'll stay on the line on the Facebook page forever, though, do they?
Yeah,
forever.
Oh yeah, forever.
Or until Facebook goes.
So how will I find that?
Thing?
Oh, just go on the Peter White morning page.
Yeah, you'll be able to find the video. Yeah,
all right.
You can download it too.
Yeah, you actually can. You can download it.
I'll download it for you.
He's gonna download it.
Well,
for
I went
you.
on the YouTube page today and listened to some of that Peter White morning show with all the celebrities and Amanda McCarthy, and I cried on my birthday.
Yes, well, we all remember that.
You cried again?
Well, when you see it on the video, you do.
But did you cry watching it?
Sometimes I tear up, yeah.
It's good to cry.
That was really coming down.
You tear up and cry, remembering the time that you teared up and cried?
Oh, yeah, sometimes.
A macho man like you ought to let it out, although you're like... letting out a little more about, you know, Peter and, you know, his underwear.
Right.
You don't have to send me any more of those texts.
Oh, my goodness. What are these important documents that you've brought?
Oh, yeah, we'll
get
to that in the second hour.
Oh, very nice. So
the first hour, we have your guest.
We have a guest calling shortly, yes.
So, are they confidential?
I don't know. Are those secret documents?
No, they're definitely not confidential. I just ran out of time on the Peter White Morning Show, so we're going to pretend that today's Monday morning.
I have.
Isn't it?
Look what I have.
It's not.
I still have them. I still bring them wherever I go. I put them under my pillow at night. I have a manila envelope full of secret documents given to me by Stephen Comley Sr., Republican candidate for president, challenging Donald Trump. And we have a call. We'll grab this. Oh, no. Did I just drop that? Oh, no. Hi,
you just dropped the secret.
Welcome to Matt Connarton Unleashed. Who's this?
Hey, guys. It's Scumpy.
Jeff Scumpy Lorenz. How are you?
Scumpy.
Merry Christmas.
How the hell are you guys, huh?
Merry holidays.
Watching the snow pile up.
Please don't say hell. It's Christmas. Yeah. We're trying to get into heaven.
Yeah.
I hear Eazy-G got a new TV. Nice job.
Yeah. What's his face? Daryl had one in his spare bedroom there, or room, and he wasn't using it, so...
What's his face?
Shipped it over to my place. Bobby antenna from Walmart, and a remote and everything. It's really nice. A 28-inch flat-screen smart TV.
Is it brand new?
So how many stations you getting?
Well, I rescanned it again today, and I got 7 channels. 6 American ones and 1 Spanish.
There you go.
Most important thing is I got 9.1 and 9.2, which gives me the WMUR. That's all you really need. You don't need those other ones.
You got twice as many channels.
You got Charlie Brown tonight.
30 years ago.
8 o'clock, yeah. And then tomorrow night, I'm going to stay awake this night, because last time I fell asleep last year, all the family in Good Times, live, with all the actors.
Nice. Live. Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah, right. I didn't see those either.
Well, I saw All in the Family, then I fell asleep, and I missed the second half of the shows. I forget which one it was, but I was really mad that I missed it.
Well, I just wanted to call. I wanted to, wish you all a Merry Christmas if I don't talk to any of you guys soon. And don't forget... DEFCON this Saturday night at the Getaway Christmas Party.
Oh,
everybody's welcome.
Even Michael Martineau?
Michael Martineau, no cover.
Okay.
Wow.
They actually have food and stuff there, too.
What time's the show?
For free?
It's actually an early show, 7 to 11.
Wow.
Is Christian Lacoste allowed, or is he banned from DEFCON?
A war on Christian, as well as the morning show.
I think it's plus 21, right?
Oh, okay.
Right?
There's a war on Christian.
Yeah.
Plus 21.
Alcohol, yeah. Served, yeah.
Right.
Oh, man. Yeah.
Well, very nice. Very nice.
All right, guys. Hey, rock on.
All right. Rock on, Scumpy.
That's a good song.
Peace.
All right. Take care. Bye-bye. All right. The great Jeff Scumpy Lorenz. I would have... tried to keep him on longer to ask him, for an update on his acting career and so forth. But we have our guest who's going to be calling in a few minutes. And in a couple of minutes, I'm going to play a new single called Hope for the Hopeless. It's his new track about domestic violence.
But the guy, the secret documents, called up the morning show last week.
I didn't even realize.
Yeah, he wanted to go on and on. Peter said, well, send me an email. We'll try to get you on the show.
Peter actually filed already his envelope full of secret documents. He filed them in a place where...
He wanted
where,
to go on and on and on, Peter, yeah. But Peter put it in.
Peter filed his in a place where no one would ever think to look for them, which I thought was smart. But I keep mine with me at all times. They're secret documents.
Are they okay, though, because you dropped them?
I hope so. I think
you might have broken some of the x-rays.
No, it's all paper. I did peek. But I'm afraid to read too much of it because I'm afraid the information in this envelope will blow my mind.
Well, you're not cleared to read it.
I am cleared. That's why he gave me the envelope. He encouraged me to read it. I'm just afraid to.
If you read classified information, it's against the law.
No, it's not classified. It's secret.
It's classified secret.
No. They're secret documents.
It goes confidential, secret, secret.
He said nothing about confidential when he handed me this envelope.
I remember what the show was last year after the All in the Family. It was the one with the George Jefferson in it.
Oh.
Oh, wow.
You remember that name of that show?
The Jeffersons.
Yep. Yeah, that was the second half of the
Moving on
and
up.
And I fell asleep. I was really mad when I woke up.
Were you, did you go into a roid rage?
No, just mad.
Did you smash your old TV? Is that why you needed a new old TV?
No, my old TV, I told the story a million times, but my old TV died because it was...
What's his name or what's his face?
What's his face?
The government re-scrambled the channels
on
August 2nd, and I couldn't get my channels in anymore. And the TV was really old, like 25 years old, and I had broken the wires a couple different
Quad
times.
Quad de visage, that's the French.
No, the king of all parts. My father had tried to fix it. He's really good with electronics, and...
Electronics.
It was automatically reset the channels all the time. It was shut off by itself. It was like a possessed television.
Yeah. Oh, look how intense he was.
It was only 2 inches too. So having like a 28-inch television is like the best thing in the world.
Wait, 28 inches.
Say that again.
The other television
was only 2 inches.
There's only 2 inches.
Well, some of us, that's part of, you know, taking steroids, Eazy-G. You should have known that.
That's like a TV on steroids.
Right.
Oh, yeah. Well, you know, you wind up with 2 inches if you're lucky.